Hello there, you're watching Proactive London. Joining us today is Kevin Flynn, the CFO at Anglo Pacific Group, joining us here to discuss the company's biggest ever acquisition. So we're going to go through this transformation process for the firm. Maybe beginning, Kevin, a warm welcome to Proactive. Take us through the highlights of the transaction, if you would.
With pleasure. Hi, Katie. Yes, this is Anglo Pacific's largest ever acquisition and probably our most significant in terms of where we see ourselves going next in terms of the direction of travel. So what we're acquiring a stream over a producing nickel and cobalt mine in Canada, Voisey's Bay, operated by one of the biggest mining companies in the world in Vale. And our stream entitles us to about 23% of the overall cobalt being produced from the operation. This stream we're acquiring for $205 million. So a very sizable transaction for us. And we're very, very excited about this. We have been on a journey for a very long time in terms of really trying to reposition Anglo Pacific away from our coal legacy and into the battery metals and electric vehicle place. And with this transaction, we think we kind of position ourselves overnight as the leading listed battery metal and electric vehicle play in the royalty and streaming sector. And we're very hopeful that we'll build on this momentum, capitalize on the moment, and really see the journey beginning from this point.
Excellent. Well, we'll get on to that strategy a bit later on, but you mentioned sizable. So talk us through how Anglo plans to finance this acquisition.
Yeah, sure. We think we've put together a pretty smart financing package, certainly helped by the quality of the asset that we're acquiring here. So we've got a three kind of legged financing plan. We're placing just under 20% of our issued share capital through a non-preemptive placing. But quite importantly, we're offering this participation to our retail shareholders through also through the primary bid online portal. So we're very kind of conscious of trying to involve our retail investors as much as we can. There is a 40% element to this of self-financing through the recycling of capital from our previously 7% position in the Labrador Iron Ore Royalty Company. Iron ore prices are trading at 9-year highs, and we have taken the view that now is a very good time to recycle capital out of something trading at long-term highs into something which we think is a very sensible entry point. Mm-hmm. And finally, we've put together a leading banking syndicate of North American lenders who are really the market leaders in financing the royalty and streaming sector in North America. And this facility is not just for this acquisition, but also for what we feel is going to come on the back of this as well. Mm-hmm.
So transforming your portfolio, right?
Absolutely, yes. So we're well financed to build on the momentum here to acquire further assets.
And what are you expecting to receive in terms of finished cobalt from the stream, and how will this translate into income, Kevin?
Yeah, sure. I mean, look, the way streams operate, slightly different to the royalty model in so much that you actually take physical product from the mine itself. So we will be receiving regular deliveries of cobalt over the course of the year. And we will then be monetizing those through a marketing arrangement that we have currently put in place with the leading trader. So for Anglo Pacific, what we're looking at for the rest of the year, depending on timing and certain points of deliveries, we would estimate revenue of between 13 to 17 million, depending on pricing. Now, the cobalt price has increased by roughly 50% in the year to date. So there's been quite a move, but you know, crucially for us, these are still at levels less than half of where they had been a couple of years ago. So we think given the spot pricing currently, we could be at the upper end of that range. And going forward, you know, this asset could reasonably generate around about $25 million per annum.
Mm-hmm. And in terms of upside for investors, what might they expect from the transaction?
I think a few things. I mean, first of all, this is an accretive transaction, you know, financed in a pretty accretive way through the recycling of capital. You know, we are quite cash generative. through our existing portfolio, and this is a producing asset as well. So, you know, very good cash flow profile. For our investors, I think the key message here is that this acquisition solves our two big, largest kind of equity issues, if you like. One being our exposure to coal, but secondly, the fact that that coal asset, Kestrel, you know, is a beginning to approach the point at which it migrates outside of our private royalty land. So this acquisition solves for both of those equity issues and provides real long-term stability to our revenue profile going forward. Mm-hmm. And we think that that really should underpin strong shareholder returns from this point on.
Kevin, you mentioned at the beginning of our conversation the electric vehicle market. We know that cobalt is a key component in batteries, of course, but can you talk about the fundamentals of the cobalt market and how Anglo is positioned with this new acquisition and how you might benefit from what's going on in the market at the moment?
Yeah, absolutely. I think you're absolutely right. Cobalt is a key ingredient for the electric vehicle story. And I think one of the things that we're convinced about is that the investment and theme of electric vehicles is not a fad, it's here to stay. I mean, if you look at all the announcements we've seen recently from the likes of Ford, Jaguar, all of the main motor companies, they're really bringing forward the dates at which they're trying to transfer all of their fleets to electric vehicles. Mm-hmm. You know, we're seeing a lot of policy changes afoot in the US under President Biden, mm-hmm. Who I believe is also going to embark on a program to change all of the governmental fleet into electric vehicles. And that could be 650,000 vehicles in its own right. So we really see the demand for cobalt mirroring the ramp up in electric vehicle usage going forward. I mean, it's still a very early stage market. But we really see only one direction going for this this sector.
And in terms of this acquisition, so you've said it's transformational, it's the biggest one ever announced for your company, but maybe what else is that going on in terms of the diary for investors to watch out for? Any more transactions in the pipeline potentially?
Yeah, we're always looking at transactions. And I think, you know, part of our frustration over the last 12 months is that we haven't been able to bring more to the table. You know, good things come to those who wait. And, you know, when we look at the quality of this acquisition, we've been working on this a very long time. We're absolutely delighted to get it over the line. I think, you know, in the royalty and streaming sector, momentum is really your key ally. And I think this transaction really gives us the platform as the go-to cobalt or electric vehicle royalty and streaming play in the UK market. So we really think that's going to open doors for us. It's going to give us profile. Over 50% of our asset value will be Canadian. We're going to make a big push in the Canadian market to increase our profile even further. So we think, you know, Anglo's profile going forward will be much enhanced. And we're sticking to our ground here. We a number of years ago really told the investor community we are moving towards this 21st century metals side of the market. We've done that. We've put copper, we've put vanadium, we've put nickel into our business. We're now putting cobalt in a big way. And our pipeline reflects that, Katie. We're very active in this space and we see deal flow.
Sounds good. Kevin Flynn, thank you so much indeed. The CFO there, Anglo Pacific Group.
Pleasure. Thank you, Katie.